In October 2018, Cargotec Investor Relations organized an investor event in Singapore. The one-day event was part of Finnish Industrial Days, hosted together with other Finnish companies Kone and Kemira. Cargotec Day included presentations by Michel van Roosendaal, president of MacGregor, as well as Peter Cederholm, president of Bruma. In addition, the day included a visit to PSA Singapore Port, which is the second largest container port in the world. PSA Singapore also uses a variety of port equipment from Kalmar. Altogether, around 30 investors and analysts participated in the event.
The sea is our life.
MacGregor aims to be recognized as the leader in intelligent maritime cargo and load handling by becoming the preferred provider of lowest total cost solutions for shipbuilders and a preferred partner for ship owners and operators through enabling highest lifecycle value. MacGregor's annual sales during the last 12 months between October 2017 and September 2018 totaled 530 million euros, and the operating profit, excluding restructuring costs, was at the level of 4.3 million euros. 80% of global shipbuilding takes place in Asia. This is visible also in MacGregor's geographical sales split, with around half of the sales revenue coming from the Asian-Pacific region. To be closer to customers, MacGregor has moved its headquarters to Singapore.
Important is, of course, that we can deal with customers in China, in Japan and Korea. We are neutral and yet at home in Asia. Also, Singapore itself is sometimes called the maritime capital of the world, and it's an ecosystem with a lot of innovation taking place, and many customers have their either local hubs here or global headquarters here, and we are part of that ecosystem. And once more, we are at home in Asia, where 80% of the shipbuilding takes place. We've moved to Asia, where most of our customers are. Of course, there are many global European ship owners, but shipbuilding takes place here. We recently signed an agreement with CSSC, the largest Chinese state-owned shipbuilding combination, where we are deepening our presence here and working more closely with our customers. But what is also key is that we are relevant for our customers with digitally enabled intelligent services. For example, this year, we basically introduced to the market the first autonomous cranes, and we are basically working in order for our solutions to operate much more automatically, much more autonomously. And that is part of that journey towards sustainable shipping, towards autonomous vessels. And we're pretty much at the forefront of this, and we believe that with that technology, we can be very relevant for our customers. Then thirdly, we look at the reality in the markets, and we see indeed that shipbuilding is still recovering, and lower for longer is sometimes mentioned. And we need to adjust our cost structure in such a way that we can produce at a level that is in line with expectations of our customers, but at the same time able to scale up when the cycle will turn for the better. And part of that means that we are strengthening our presence here in Japan, Korea, China, and Asia in particular, and happily building up our capabilities to scale up later on. So on the merchant side, we clearly see a situation where lower for longer is what best describes the situation. However, things are also developing slowly in a positive way. People are investing more and more into this market, but at a very, very slow pace. Sustainability is very important, and you'll see the sulfur cap and also the greenhouse gas emissions pledge of the International Maritime Organization. So you'll see investment going into those directions, and we as MacGregor can play a right role in that place. Of course, also you see a continued consolidation and a strengthening of, for example, Chinese ship owners. So that is describing the merchant side. On the offshore side, things are still in a difficult place, but some leading indicators are positive. One leading indicator is the oil price, which is now around 75, and that allows the whole industry to place more investments and make more money. And about investments, we also see that the sentiment, which initially was very much focused on shale, is now flipping in favor of deep water again. The whole ecosystem of deep water offshore has made a lot of cost reductions, and unfortunately we have been part of those cost reductions, but as a result of that, that industry is now much more attractive, and you'll see that the economies of scale for deep water offshore are actually now basically more attractive compared to shale oil production. And oil and gas still needs to grow in absolute terms in order to basically supply energy demand of a growing world population and growing energy demand of that population. So we see some positive trends there as well. And then maybe a few words around fishery, that is basically placing it into the area where we have made an investment in the RAP area. Also there we see growth opportunities, not just in fishing, but also in aquaculture or fish farming. So in general terms, still a difficult environment, but with some, cautious reason for optimism.